Ministry of External Affairs and the Minister Sushma Swaraj presented their case as far as the Doklam standoff with China is concerned. Let's listen into the minister and then we'll get reactions.
अपने विकास में आर्थिक मदद चाहिए और इसलिए जब प्रधानमंत्री कहते हैं सबका साथ सबका विकास का मतलब केवल देश के अंदर का नहीं है मैं चाहता हूं कि भारत की प्रगति में मेरे हर पड़ोसी देश का विकास हो ये जो भावना है ये पड़ोसी देशों को आश्वस्त भी करती है और ये उनको ये भी कहती है कि भारत का अगर विकास होगा तो भारत के विकास का लाभ हमें भी मिलेगा इसलिए सामरिक क्षमता बढ़ाने की बजाय आज आर्थिक क्षमता बढ़ाने की ज़रूरत है और मैं बहुत ज़्यादा अदब से ये कहना चाहूँगी कि हमारी जो आर्थिक क्षमता बढ़ रही है उसमें भी बहुत बड़ा इन्वेस्टमेंट चाइना से आ रहा है
Well, that's the External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj speaking in Parliament, saying that diplomatic talks are the best way to try and de-escalate matters between China and India. Brahma Chalani, strategic thinker and author, joins us. Mr. Chalani, always a pleasure to have you here on CNBC TV 18. You have basically said that China has become this habitual victim, so to speak, when it comes to border standoffs with India. And in fact, you believe that India has done the right thing by calling out China's bluff at this point in time. But given what we've heard from the minister today and where things currently stand, how do you see this now de-escalating?
Minister Sushma Swaraj made a very good statement in Parliament and she emphasized the importance of diplomacy, which has been India's main talking point. And that stands in stark contrast to China's war rhetoric and its mounting of threats against India. But in terms of how this standoff might play out, we have to bear in mind that this standoff is only one in a series of incursions and encroachments that India has faced in recent years. We have a serious problem along the border with transgressions and incursions happening regularly. And therefore, this standoff should end in a way that results not just a standoff, but also brings genuine border peace. India does not want recurrent Chinese incursions.
You're saying that we need to move towards being able to not just de-escalate this specific standoff, but improve relations between India and China. When we talk about the possibility of diplomatic engagement on this specific issue, what would you expect India to put on the table and what would you expect India to ask China to put on the table? Also, the minister saying that we need to look at this relationship holistically. We need to look at the economic engagement between both countries as well. Given the priorities on both sides, what form and fashion do you see the diplomatic engagement starting from here on this specific issue?
I think the last 2 days of statements from China and India underscore what the differences and how to bridge the divide. First, yesterday, China, in a 15-page compilation of previously stated claims and demands, said that India's unconditional and immediate withdrawal from Doklam is a prerequisite to ending the standoff. And today, Sushma Swaraj, in her statement, said that border peace is a prerequisite for developing smooth ties. So there is this vast gap. India wants border peace, while China is focused on this one particular incident, the standoff. It wants to end it largely on its terms. It often uses diplomacy for its strategic objectives, while India believes that diplomacy can yield enduring peace. And I think that gap has to be bridged, and that gap can be bridged only if India brings requisite military strength and diplomatic determination to the negotiating table.
Do you feel confident, Brahma Chalani, this is my final question to you, do you feel confident that given the statements from both sides, we are likely to see a cooling off, so to speak?
I don't see an immediate threat of a war because contrary to the Chinese psychological warfare campaign against India, there is no Chinese military buildup on the Tibetan plateau and certainly not along the Himalayan borders with India. Indian intelligence has found no evidence of Chinese military buildup. So there is no immediate danger of a war. But I think the Chinese war rhetoric against India that we have seen for the past 6 weeks, that is likely to continue. But I think the Chinese are in a jam because militarily they don't have a credible option to come out a winner from this standoff. And diplomatically, they've boxed themselves in a corner. And therefore, they very much need India's help to extricate themselves from a hopeless situation on the Doklam Plateau. But India's goal, as I said, has to be just not ending the standoff, but ensuring that there will be no more Doklams and Devsangs and Chumars in the months and years to come.
Well, Brahma Talani, we'll have to leave it there. Appreciate you joining us here on CNBC TV 18. That's the latest on the current standoff between India.